St. Louis de Montfort. St. Louis de Montfort is one of the greatest modern saints of all time. His most famous work on Our Lady is the Marian masterpiece, True Devotion to Blessed Virgin. St. Louis de Montfort is known as the saint of Marian consecration. He preached and wrote about Mary as the Lady of Breathless Beauty, the masterpiece of God's creation, and the surest and most effective way to follow Jesus Christ. He taught that as the Mother of God and as the spiritual mother of God's children, she is the quickest and easiest way to Jesus, the heart of the mystical body of Christ. As the mold of creaturely holiness, Mary is understood as the ultimate saint-maker and thus a mediatrix in our sanctification.
Saint Maximilian Kolbe. Saint Maximilian was a true knight of the Rosary and prayed it every day of his priestly life. He required that all members pray the Rosary every day. He preached and spoke frequently on the power of the Rosary, taught 3 hours about the history of the Rosary, and offered catechesis on the mysteries associated with the Rosary. As a knight of the Immaculata, he understood the Rosary to be spiritual sword. In 1941, when he was captured by the Nazis, one of the Nazi officers noticed a rosary hanging from his habit and used it as a means to abuse him. The Nazi officers violently grabbed the rosary, held the crucifix to the saint's face and asked him if he truly believed in Jesus Christ and the rosary. Saint Maximilian's response was yes, for which he was brutally beaten. Saint Maximilian is both a martyr of a charity and knight of the Rosary. Thank you.
Saint Padre Pio. Saint Pio, who lived the life of a victim soul, has been called by God to share in a special way in the sufferings of Jesus and to make reparation for the sins of the world. He is referred to as the Living Rosary, since as a mystic who bore the wounds of Christ, he lived the mysteries of the Rosary more directly than most, and always had the Rosary in his hand. As a youth, his tremendous love for the Rosary emerged from the example set by his family. Every evening, his family would gather together to pray the Rosary. It is said that St. Pio's silent sermon has always been the Rosary. He prayed the Rosary several times during the day. Once when asked by his religious superiors how many rosaries he had prayed that day, he replied 34. On another occasion, when asked by a Franciscan confrere what prayer was most pleasing to Mary, St. Pio instantly replied that it was the Rosary, as she taught it herself and continued to stress on its importance in her various apparitions. A day before he was to die, when asked to give a final message to the people around him, St. Pio's advice for them was to love Mary, to make her known, and to always pray the Rosary. Thank you.
Pope Leo
XIII.
From his youth, Pope Leo XIII had a strong devotion to Mary. Pope Leo XIII was deeply influenced by St. Louis de Montfort's Marian thought. He promoted the Brown Scapular, instituted the Feet of Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal, wrote an apostolic letter promoting Marian pilgrimages, especially Lourdes. Following the thought of St. Bernard of Clairvaux, he thought that a Christian trying to live their faith without Mary is comparable to a bird trying to fly without wings. In his Marian writings, he emphasized that it is Our Lady who is capable of bringing about obedience to the Vicar of Christ among all Christians. He was the first pope to have his voice recorded. On the recording, he is singing the Hail Mary.
Saint John Paul II. Saint John Paul II had a filial love for Mary. After losing his earthly mother, At a very early age, he entrusted himself to a lady's care and had complete confidence in her. He was greatly influenced by the Marian writings of Saint Louis de Montfort and said that true devotion to Mary was a turning point in his life. When he was John Paul II, he was elected as the Vicar of Christ. He chose as his pontifical motto a phrase "Totus Tuus" from the Marian devotion, which means "All yours, Mary." In his catechetical talks on Mary, he emphasized that it is impossible to understand the Church unless they look to Mary, since no other person can better introduce us to the knowledge of Christ than his mother. Saint John Paul II promoted the Marian sodality and the Legion of Mary everywhere he went. Saint John Paul II took the opportunity to speak to a lady as our maternal mediatrix, the masterpiece of God's mercy, the pattern of Christian holiness, and the woman of Eucharist who leads the spiritual children to the real presence of Christ. In 1984, he consecrated the world to the Immaculate Heart and fulfilled Mary's request at Fatima. He led by example by bringing Our Lady into everything he said and did.
Venerable Fulton J. Sheen, as a priest, bishop and archbishop, he always promoted the rosary. He considered the rosary to be therapeutic since it was a form of meditative prayer which involved kissing the crucifix and caressing it tenderly. He always encouraged the people to pray the rosary while working, walking and driving. He believed that the rosary had the power to transform both individuals and the society at large. He often reminded the intellectually elite that they were depriving themselves of great graces if they failed to humble themselves and pray the rosary. Thank you.